Improve your painting skills with lessons from pro artist Fishman with his course Level Up Your Digital Painting Skills Beginner to Advanced. The regular price for this course with 31 hours of content is usually $109, but is currently on sale for just $49. And if you buy it with my affiliate link below, you will also be supporting the channel at no extra cost to yourself. Starting something is relatively easy. Whether that's learning to draw or any other skill, you've probably done this over and over with different things, telling yourself you'll learn an instrument and then only doing it for a week before losing interest. Really sticking to these things is the hard part, regardless of how easy it may be in the short term. The most important piece of advice I think I can give you is to start slow with this stuff. Your stamina and tolerance for doing whatever skill it is that you're working on is pretty low at the moment because you've only just started, so you'll be easily overwhelmed or burned out. You've probably seen people try to suddenly push into something like a diet because they're motivated in that moment, but it almost never works as soon as they start to burn out. Progress comes from working on something every single day, so do what you realistically can on a daily basis and make sure you end the day before you're tired of drawing. You want to make sure you end on a high note, so you're motivated to come back the next day. That said, don't rely on motivation. You really need to just do it, and this is also why you need to start small. It needs to be something actionable and immediate instead of relying on feeling like suddenly drawing for 5 hours a day. That just is not going to happen. And as time goes by and you work on small realistic goals, what you're able to do on a daily basis will gradually increase. When I started drawing 6 years ago, even fitting in an hour of art was extremely hard and frustrating. I hated the fact that I was bad at it, and I wasn't really in control of my life enough to dedicate an hour a day to something productive that I wasn't forced into doing by someone else. At this point though, drawing for 5 or 6 hours a day is relatively easy because I've built up to that point, and you just need to do the same over a period of years. Setting a schedule is really important here. You won't get anything done or even know what you are doing without one. It also helps visualize just how much of a day 1 hour is. For example, if you set a schedule that covers a 24-hour period and you just have one checkbox, which is draw for 1 hour, that should probably be a relatively easy thing to fit into a day. Make sure you hold yourself accountable and keep track of what you actually are and aren't doing. If you do miss one day, then that's unfortunate, but make a point of coming back the next day. I see a lot of people feel like because they haven't done something for a day, they failed and it's over. What you need to focus on isn't where you failed, but what you can do next time better. Just make sure you do that hour the next day, or if that's too hard to consistently do, maybe even do 10 minutes a day, something that you can realistically do, and then again, build up from there. Just accept your current limits and don't try to immediately push beyond them. Input is also really important. You'll lose your desire to draw and you won't improve as much if you're not inputting information. You want to make sure you're learning and going through things, and in general, I think this works best with structured lessons, especially for a beginner who won't know where to look next after doing one completely out of context lesson. The best, in my opinion, are drawabox.com and Proko's tutorials that you can find on YouTube. There are some really great books as well, for example, Andrew Loomis's books are going to be a great way to go through and keep inputting really useful, actionable information that will improve your art on a daily basis. Make sure you also consume art that you like, the art that inspired you to do this in the first place. Focus on what you're trying to learn, what they've done better than you, and how you can move in their direction more so you can make your art closer to your goals. Another important point is to save your art and focus on your personal progress. This is a huge thing for me. I've had multiple times where I was ready to completely give up with art and I was frustrated because I wasn't learning enough. But then I'd go back through all the art that I'd saved and I would be able to pick out parts where I have and haven't improved. If you can see where you haven't improved, then you now understand where you should improve next. And if you can see where you have improved, then that's clear proof that you can improve and you will continue to as long as you push through that rough patch that you're in. While the alternative is to just not work on this at all, where you won't improve at all. I'm not the kind of person to just throw out quotes, but there is one quote that I really love that I think people could gain a lot from, and that is, "The best time to plant a tree was 20 years ago, the second best time is now." I really think everyone would benefit from keeping this in mind and reminding yourself that just because up until now you haven't improved your art to the level that you would have liked to, 5 years from now you could either be 5 years better or you could just be sitting where you are now because you haven't worked on it. It's really up to you and you need to put in that time if you want to improve. If you're a complete beginner, you need to accept that you are a beginner and that your art is probably bad. It's probably really bad. But the reality is, you are the average and you just have to accept that you're not good because you're on this journey to get better. It takes a lot of humility to get through the first steps of learning anything, really. Most people give up immediately because they're bad at things. If you can get past that first step, accept that you're not good now, and that with work you will improve, you're well on your way to becoming quote-unquote talented, or someone who simply works on these skills to get better at them. And my last point is that I can personally promise you that you will improve if you work on art or anything else, really. You don't need to know everything right now. Just focus on yourself and how you can make what you want to make better. Important information will come to you as long as you're keeping an eye out for it. My art is still not that good, to be honest. Every time I finish something, I look at what the people that I like are making, and I'm clearly so far behind, and I need to get better in so many ways. And maybe I'll never be the greatest artist on the planet. Maybe I'll never even be particularly good. But I can see with my own eyes that I have clearly improved, and I know how to keep improving, and I'm going to work to keep improving. And, you know, maybe for someone who has dedicated their whole life to art, I will be the worst artist in that category, the lowest skill level. But at the end of the day, I'll still be better than all the people who didn't try or gave up early. So hopefully some of this helps. If you have any other questions, feel free to leave them in the comments. I would also recommend you watch my video for how to start learning to draw, more specifically with where you should focus on to improve your skills, whereas this video was more about how to make sure you actually do it and some important mindset stuff, I think, to make sure you don't just give up because it's too difficult. If you want to improve your art for free and make friends who are dealing with similar art struggles to you, you can join the Learning to Draw Discord server. And if you want to see my art before it goes up in these videos, you can follow me on Twitter and Instagram. That's going to be it for this video. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.